Forsted, press out. Adam Viola. Good, on the back. Left front stance, left rising block. Good, step forward. Just what you were doing the other day. Reach. Reach. Hunt. Reach. Go. Monte. Get on, okay. Get on, okay. Shuran Uchiyuki, is that what we're calling it?
That sounds right to me, sir.
5-7-4. H! Eight. べ。Vertical fist. Lead side. So that will be Oizuke, Shuran Tadezuke. So what are we calling lead side? Lead thrust.
Oh, lead versus reverse?
Yes. Oizuke versus Yakuzuke. So it'll be Tate Oizuke. Is that correct, Scott?
Tadezuke. Oizuke is what you're calling the turnover punch, I think, unless you changed it. I don't know if there's a term.
There's something different.
Tateski, Oizuki, Yaku, Tate, Yaku, Oizuki.
Yeah, there's another name for front.
Yeah, I don't have that either.
And that's what I thought. Okay. All right, ready?
H! Hey!
Well, that. follow his count, okay? Don't worry about this count right here.
I'll throw some of those. Not better. Now, sometimes it'll be a little bit better if you raise your head a little bit so it's flat. There you go. If the engine is fine with
it. Turn that.
And go through to the whole thing.
And then
they've changed it.
From here to my elbow. I'm going to pull and strike.
You were the one telling me about the other
side.
Like this.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Got to stop this one on this side. One more time.
Over.
Prep. Step. Uncoil.
You got that.
Prep.
Any more coil than
that? Step.
All right,
20-20-20
there. Make something about that belt. Kind of short there. You got a little bow tie there.
Yeah, this is actually rather 3-year-old for
it. Zero. A little blood in your face, so that's good. It's a reddish. Yeah, I like the red.
I think you're red. That's good, sir.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah, I can see you're getting a little pale, a little pink with that one.
Yeah.
Alright. Go on, okay. Watch out all the way.
Yes.
No.
Hey! lower back, go back to your right.
It's a hand forward.
Let's try it again. One column more.
Hey! Hey! Hey!
From
your ear, my head, I can grab all the side of my head.
Huh?
Here, all the way down here. That's the fundamentals. You don't want to start shortchanging them now because you got to do that forever.
Front foot force means the front leg. Yeah, I'm sorry, your rear foot. Yes, the front stance there when you step back.
Hey!
Foot has to be straight. Yeah. If it turns inside a bit,
your shoulder,
outside, not even a slight upside.
Okay. Doing this.
So you want to have this,
here's it. This.
Maybe in a little bit.
So
right? So that.
Back to the beginning.
No bueno.
Yes, I should.
One cup. Yes.
So on the step back, front stance, cup one. I know you say stay on the right, but I know he's going to be straight.
Yeah,
just trying to do it. You start out here and then go up.
Once you get into your stance, you stay all the way same
low
until you go back to your area.
So on your punch on this level, you can dissect it on the top of your forearm.
There you go.
Next motion.
Aye!
The heels are going to turn out.
Alright, back to your. One count, two moves. One count, two moves.
Yes.
Ready?
One count, one move.
Aye!
Turn the back foot and raise up to the last. Now, motion. Stand back to our side. Face it forward. And you turn this heel back up underneath you, just like you did before. It's going to come across the foot. Now, we're going to take that heel again and we're going to take it back out in your foot stance again. And we're going to drive this up into a rising block.
You what?
But you want to make sure this is over this ear.
Oh, I think I got an idea.
If you allow this to flip this way, pull my head it all over.
You got Tendo Gata?
Keep this.
Yes, sir.
You got Kino yet?
More or less, sir.
Let's go with Tendo. Let's go with Tendo. All right, ready?
You turn your wrist. You want to keep the knuckles in line with the bones. Yeah. Now we push.
We were talking about the salsa hip.
Right. Yeah. Did you figure it out?
She's here doing his job.
I'm happy for you to pick on him, sir.
I haven't been in class with him, but my suggestion is we just haven't hit him hard enough.
Because that part is, I was trying not to just now, but I still was doing it.
It got better, I gotta say. But, we kind of figured out that he was,
like preload.
I do this.
If I'm here, as I step, I'm gonna start.
Because I looked at it as load, load, and I think that got in my brain.
Instead of that.
Because if you wait till after.
I thought it was easy. One more time.
And do. Like that.
Hey!
Llegaste a conocer a Isa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
you're gonna load it that year as you step.
Take one with.
Forward, load that hand that's already out there, that's in here. Do a down block with the same hand that you pressed. Just like that. That's right. Okay, next motion. You're gonna do a down block this way. As you feel it, it's already in the sheet going. So load, heel, and then across.
Change my muscle.
Nope, the other hand.
Lay back, like, just like that.
Here's the other secret. The first time you did it, you were blocking all with one hand. The second time you said for it, you're blocking all with the other hand. Okay? So this hand is doing all the blocking.
Sometimes Mother Nature's giving us two hands just for decoration.
Where your heel spins out, the hand turns up in the middle outside. Just like that. And now the heel's underneath you. Hand comes across to the middle inside.
Because it's the same way.
Still looking forward. Here's the bad guy. Still here. All of us. Bad guy. See, the thing is what he's doing is
you're going to do yoidox, which is fine.
Load.
You're going to make your whole yoidox move. Don't push your leg and lean into it.
Back heel. Good.
Get your body motion. Get your body into it. So
front stance. Middle outside block. Front stance. Front stance. Front stance. And middle outside. Just like that.
All right, go ahead.
This
one
you prep. You load it over here.
We've talked about this equation before. Right? Force equals mass times acceleration.
Yes.
How many variables affect force?
Now, this one.
Pardon me, sir?
How many variables affect force? How many things can we change based on this equation to increase force?
Either your mass or your acceleration, sir.
Okay, I'll hear two.
The same hand that's out.
Anybody say difference is two? It's actually three.
Step, load, and double.
Acceleration is actually distance over time squared. So if we want to flesh this out, it's mass over distance by time squared.
Next motion.
So we can how can we increase mass?
So
if we increase mass, we can increase force. Yes? How can we increase mass?
Eat more skills, sir. Yeah.
More specific, but absolute.
Next motion.
Depending on how far away you start before we build our momentum towards the end result.
And
about how much do you think my arm weighs? Whatever it is.
That guy's still here.
I lean on it. If I increase the mass, you're hitting it. Absolutely. If I draw it full body, have I increased the mass? I've increased my mass, I've decreased distance.
Okay. Next motion.
Moving the whole body is how we increase mass, up to the maximum of whatever mass you have.
Next motion, punch.
Increasing distance. How do we do that?
Front foot goes back.
From the movement of the
move. Instead of a big hand jab, stepping Yoizuki. You increase distance. Yeah, versus that.
And then relax into ready position.
What happens if we increase time? We go slower.
Why?
He can move out of the way, sir.
Well, yeah, no, based on his equation.
It means ready. It's a good position.
Build more.
Come on, you guys did math before.
Decrease your acceleration.
Right, you decrease acceleration, you decrease force. So you have to, decrease time. You have to move faster. Square. So faster.
I'm gonna mirror you. I'm gonna do what you do.
So instead of being on it, John showed it perfectly. Moving the whole body, increase mass, increase distance.
You yeah.
This. Move quicker.
This.
Eight.
Oh. This.
Back at it.
All right, now you guys understand that when he said about increasing mass, is not like really increasing mass, right? Like we're just increasing the force. When you increase mass, I'm meaning that all of a sudden I can go, I weigh 300 pounds.
Heel.
Right? That would be like increasing mass, right? Getting bigger or heavier.
Heel.
Okay? So you're not really literally doing that, but you're increasing your body in connection with the strike.
Load with the hand.
That's falling from the sky. The more you fall, the harder you.
He's talking about mass, and I agree.
Load.
My description was a little better. If I hit with the arm, I'm hitting with that mass. I increase the mass by moving my whole body, hitting with my whole body. So yes, as you said, I can't miraculously turn into Hulk yet, although I'm working on it.
But in other words, when you increase mass, that's why I say literacy. Yeah. That's kind of because the concept that you're not going to be able to increase your mass unless you eat a whole bunch of cakes or the holidays. If you increase your mass a little bit, you're going to be heavier.
But if you're moving and you punch, though, technically you could punch heavier than your weight because of the movement.
There we go. Now it's about moving your body and making that connection when you're doing that. So if I move the body and I hit off timing, I lost that momentum, I lost that force, I lost that mass. So you got to put it together with the strike. Okay? I understand what he meant. I just wanted to make sure that you guys were right. You know what? This guy told me how to increase my mass. Like, what do you mean?
Put a maybe just a fine point for my peace of mind on it. It's you're increasing the amount of mass hitting your opponent. Hitting my arm is that, hitting my whole body. That's just increasing the mass of hitting your opponent. Yes, you're not physically increasing the mass of your body. All right. Yeah, I'll figure that out. I swear he could.
Yep. All right, go for it. Come on.
One count. One half. Okay. Go home. Okay. Each.
Here. There we go.
Now,
there. Good.
Now punch it. Yame.
Pinky finger up.
Yame. All the way through. Okay? Go home and look at it.
stance, keep your hold strong.
Yep.
Remember,
cool.
Yep.
I guess. Now you're looking at him, because he's the one that still punches at you. Next one is just what?
The one like you're going to
punch. And then punch. Then, now, you see where you're punching?
So I was bad. And you just start.
You want to punch.
Step back to the right, step in the right high punch.
This is what's important, is you want to kind of move towards the center.
Real punch.
You want to push, you want to punch throughout that side, because you'll never hit anything, you'll go on top.
Step in, low punch, and just slap back.
And you want to kind of triangle, you know, come down.
Ten times.
When you finish, it should be in the center of your body.
And this is what I'm trying to find.
So anytime you're not dealing with this person, you have to use your body as the guide for where everything's at. So if I'm blocking, my shoulders, so I'm not trying to do this.
Well, show me.
That's okay. Stop here.
I really have to still be parallel.
Yeah, I'm exposed from here to here, right? So you want to block.
You're stepping back with this.
Okay, it's got to come over here, in this case, where Chico. Chico will actually allow you to just slide more over. See, I didn't move my hand. It went from a front stance, my body's constricted, now. See that? That's the reason why we're changing Chico when we're doing all the inside. Because we need just a little bit more.
No punches.
Okay, one count, one move, same time.
Push it.
Ready? And you go in.
Two more.
Eight.
Yes, sir. Yeah, the angle is still slightly soft, and then you go
eight.
I'm going to avoid that.
I got it. Son?
What is our generic target, our default target?
Moving this arm this way.
Sure.
You can turn the head.
Solar flare.
That's what you keep this straight.
If someone is throwing a punch on your solar flare, is the middle outside block your best option? No, it's too low. Middle outside block and middle inside block are meant for the upper chest. Anything from about the top part of my solar plexus, like the end of my sternum, down is down block area. From above my solar plexus to about my collarbone, just below my collarbone, those are the middle block area. I'm saying above that rising block. So when we're talking kata, middle punch is solar plexus. When we're doing drills that involve a middle outside block or a middle inside block, middle punch becomes the middle of the sternum. You've got to bring it up for your opponent to work the two blocks. If you're aiming the solar plexus, it's going to change the drill. Second part. As the Uki, you're the most important person in a two-person drill. You must target correctly. If you're supposed to be a down, low punch, you've got to be a low punch. It can't be off to the side, it can't be high punch. That's how people get hurt. All right, so let's face each other. Once I want you to load and start first, I want you to go slow, go through that entire series of events and hold on the last. It's low punch, first low punch and down block. Middle outside block. You're going to do that. Exactly. So, step back, punch, step forward, middle outside block.
Just like that.
Step back again. You say punch, step, same block.
That one is going to be close to correct.
Okay, Allison, don't throw off the side.
Good.
You must target the punch correct. All right. Start over, do that much. Nice and slow.
You're fine on this side.
Yes.
See?
You say you got some of Chino?
Yeah.
You got a little bit
of Chino? That's closest to you. That was through all of them.
Maybe you can be slow, you can follow him.
One more.
Chino.
Yeah. There you go. Mate. Rear hand, real quick punch. No, then you go right in. Right on hand.
Yeah, there you go.
I can't
go right in. All right, start over. Purposes of this drill, the punching person is stepping back. Now, why?
Just another way.
Okay, besides the
middle outside block.
Stepping could be on the offensive.
What are we doing?
Stepping and blocking.
Being on the offensive.
Yeah, what are we doing? What are we doing?
Put it all together. Okay?
I've always said it like 20 times.
I don't know, I just knew it.
Don't do that.
Chino Kata.
Chino Kata.
Okay, well, I'm sorry, I thought there was a given.
I'm serious.
Yes.
Times the most obvious answer, two plus two is, I got it, I don't know. In Chino Kata, as we're doing in the last side block, which way are we going? Forward, right.
Because when you do things like this.
So for this drill, we're gonna go forward with the block.
I'm in a superior position, therefore I'm challenging you.
From the practical standpoint.
See what I mean?
Do we typically step back and block?
I know, but I'm showing you the code of etiquette.
But our opponent gets a vote in this.
So it would be bad form for me to stand here and do this.
Where do we have to do this?
A little less because I'm senior, but I mean, it's really not good for.
Been into this mess, as this person comes forward.
Japanese disrespect.
If I have the opportunity, I'm gonna stick him in.
So, we're giving you Japanese words.
I get a vote, you know, the opponent gets a vote in this.
Yeah?
So, yeah.
So, we're in a lot of side block.
Where do we almost.
Stepping and blocking.
I'll say that we do, we always practice that step back punch.
Don't think about it too much, now you're.
There's one drill we do repeatedly that shows that.
Good.
Step back.
Good.
Look forward.
One more. One more. Mate, rear leg turtle. Now, just take that hand that's there.
Tension knuckle five.
And there, bring pass of this area center. Now, stepping and the little side block.
Whoever was starting.
Stepping and the little side block.
No, I'm watching over here.
So step, lift, and come across. Right. Easiest way to think about this is you have a rope between this hand and this elbow. So when this hand's out here like this, I'm going to fold it over and I'm going to prep this. I got a rope between this hand and this elbow. So when this the elbow comes across. Keep your arm over your leg. Tuck this in here like this. My next motion is I fold this down and I lift this up. And now I get a rope between this hand and this elbow. So when I make my next stretch, I pull the rope and pull my elbow back. So it looks like this in the long run.
Step back, palm.
Okay.
Good.
It's just the beginning of it. We'll figure out what works for you. Okay, so the next motion, that hand should be up and facing that direction. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to take our hand that's there.
Oh, we did it. Oh, sorry.
Pull that rope. Just like that. Pull that one in here. Good. Pull it down. Lift it up. The other one up. And step and pull it across. Good. I heard it too. Both of us looked at the door exactly the same time.
Yeah, I saw you guys doing it, but I didn't hear it.
First I thought it was just like a car, you know, run over a bob or something, and then went two more right after.
Step.
I was just moving.
Alright, stretch up.
Kyosuke, Shoni, right? Shoni, right? Otagani, right?
From the 23rd to the 3rd.
I'm gonna miss you guys.
Yeah, right, that's what I'm thinking, really.
But Sheehan, maybe he might be around, I'll be around, so if you guys want to do the text, you guys want to do one of those, hey, I'll feel like doing something and release some of that coquito and release some of that, all that stuff, then, you know, message us. We'll get together. He has the key. You have a key. So, you know, if it's too early, I'll be asleep. But if anything, next week, it's going to be one of those. You hook up with one of our Sheehans and say, hey, are you going to do something? Yes, no? You know, you guys can come in.
Is this?
Okay. Hey. And if you guys, let's say you couldn't get a hold of anybody, but you want to do something, you're like, I want to do something. I want to get out of here and do something, all right? You go to that gate over there, all right? It's left down. You open that up, and you can train back there. So once you close it back up again, all right? And
make sure you don't turn on fans.
Don't spread it, all right?
So
left down, you open that thing, and you can train. And
yes.
You don't find any of them. So Dojo will be here for you guys, just in case you need to get something out of your chest. Sometimes that happens.
Is
you got all the
that
fans
Christmas
in
here
with
the favorite
next
Christmas
dinner. So it's the 2 weeks, the Christmas and week of New Year's, right?
Correct.
It's
on the 23rd to the 3rd.
Just
back on at the 6th.
And back on the 6th.
That's going to hurt.
Gravy removal kicking day.
But this week it will be normal. This week is normal.
Yes.
Is this?
Yes.
Do it, guys. Do it.